Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. You may recall from the previous update that we had critical geometry on the 14th and 15th. There was a convergence of planetary and lunar geometry that had the potential to trigger a major earthquake around mid-7 magnitude. So far, that didn't happen, but we do see an obvious seismic response on the 16th with three borderline 6 magnitude earthquakes, including one in eastern Turkey. I will come to that in a minute. We also see clustering in the higher 5 magnitude range on the 20th following the next lunar conjunctions with Venus and Uranus. And there was also a planetary conjunction in there with Mercury on the 19th. So let's have a look at the magnitude 6 earthquake in eastern Turkey, because that deserves some attention. It happened in a region that was a part of a sequence of strong and major earthquakes since 2020. In January, on January 24th, 2020, there was a magnitude 6.8 earthquake in eastern Turkey, and the most recent event last week happened slightly to the west. And of course, we had these major earthquakes in February 2020 to the west, magnitude 7.8, 7.5. We had magnitude 6 earthquake aftershocks, and we see that there is a gap in there between the strong earthquake in 2020 and the major earthquakes in 2023. There is a gap. And the 6-pointer occurred in that gap towards the east. There is still a part of the fault that has not ruptured, and this could easily have been a higher 6 to 7 magnitude earthquake. Instead, it was just 6.0. But there is still part of the fault that has not ruptured, and one day in the future, it will rupture, and that, if we're lucky, it will be borderline 6 strong earthquakes, but it is also possible that it will rupture in one go and there will be a larger earthquake, like a higher 6 to 7 magnitude. Keep in mind that there is still a gap in there. Also to the south, starting near Aleppo and then further south, if we look at history, there have been major earthquakes along the Dead Sea Transform. And one day that will happen again, maybe in a sequence. But we do know that the recent sequence in the last 4 years has significantly changed the stress distribution along the Arabian Plate, the East Anatolia Fault, and it also affects the North Anatolia Fault. So that's the seismic activity that we had, a strong earthquake in eastern Turkey, and I put this in context because this is significant. It's very important to be aware of the seismic risk in the region. Also, if you look at atmospheric fluctuations, the first indication of upcoming stronger seismic activity in the region was on October 4th, and again, slightly to the east, on October 14th. And this, like I said, can be a significant indicator of upcoming stronger seismic activity. We really shouldn't dismiss these atmospheric fluctuations. So let's have a look at the SSGI graph for the coming time frame up until the 30th of October. We really do not have a very critical geometry, no convergence of planetary conjunctions or anything. What we do have, what we had yesterday, was a planetary conjunction with, a lunar conjunction with Jupiter. And that can, in a worst case scenario, result in a stronger seismic event later today or tomorrow, around the 23rd. That is the potential. Again, we didn't have a major earthquake following the really critical geometry on 14, 15 October. So the question is, what's going to happen with the lunar conjunction with Jupiter? Like I said, around the 23rd, there is the potential for a stronger seismic event. If you look further on the SSGI graph, we primarily see a right angle geometry, planetary geometry like Mercury, Venus, Jupiter is not too critical. And we see the next lunar conjunctions on the 27th and 28th. That will be with Saturn and with Neptune. And that can result in some stronger seismic activity, clustering higher 5, maybe into the 6 magnitude range around the 29th. And if you look at the Earth-Moon-Mars conjunction, that's on the 24th, may indicate upcoming stronger seismic activity around the 24th, 25th, give or take one day. It's difficult to say, to pinpoint the exact date. We never give exact dates because we don't know. There can be plus minus one day, but we know approximately where the seismic increase is more likely to occur. like I said, 24th, 25th, give or take one day, and also on the 29th, give or take one day, because of the lunar conjunctions with Saturn and Neptune. So it doesn't look too critical at this point in the coming week. If there are indications of upcoming larger seismic activity, we will do additional updates. Check out the website for the latest updates, also the atmospheric fluctuations in our social media channels as well. Like I said, they can be significant, as we have seen here with Eastern Turkey. Stay safe. Until next time.